Let Us Free Ireland, published in The Workers' Republic, 1899, written by James Connolly. Let us free Ireland. Never mind such base, carnal thoughts as concern work and wages, healthy homes, or lives unclouded by poverty. Let us free Ireland. The rack-renting landlord, is he not also an Irishman? And wherefore should we hate him? Nay, let us not speak harshly of our brother, yea, even when he raises our rent. Let us free Ireland, the profit-grinding capitalist, who robs us of three-fourths of our fruits of our labour, who sucks the very marrow of our bones when we are young, and then throws us out in the street, like a worn-out tool when we are grown prematurely old in his service. Is he not also an Irishman, and mayhap a patriot? And wherefore should we think harshly of him? Let us free Ireland, the land that bred and bore us, and the landlord who makes us pay for permission to live upon it. Whoop it up for liberty! Let us free Ireland, says the patriot who will not touch socialism. Let us join together and crush the brutal Saxon. Let us join together, says he, all classes and creeds. And says the town worker, after we have crushed the Saxon and the freed Ireland, what will we do? Oh, then you can go back to your slums, same as before. Whoop it up for liberty! And says the agricultural workers, after we have freed Ireland, what then? Oh, then you can go scraping around for the landlord's rent or the moneylender's interest, same as before. Whoop it up for liberty! After Ireland is free, says the patriot who won't touch socialism, we will protect all classes, and if you won't pay your rent, you will be evicted, same as now. But the evicting party, under command of the sheriff, will wear green uniforms, and the harp without the crown, and the warrant turning you out on the roadside will be stamped with the arms of the Irish Republic. Now, isn't that worth fighting for? And when you cannot find employment, and, giving up the struggle of life in despair, enter the poorhouse, the band of the nearest regiment of the Irish army will escort you to the poorhouse door, to the tune of St. Patrick's Day. Oh, it will be nice to live in those days. With the green flag floating o'er us, an ever-increasing army of unemployed workers walking around about under the green flag, wishing they had something to eat, same as now, whoop it up for liberty. Now, my friend, I am also Irish, but I'm a bit more logical. The capitalist, I say, is a parasite on industry, as useless in the present stage of our industrial development as any other parasite in the animal or vegetable world is to the life of the animal or vegetable upon which it feeds. The working class is the victim of this parasite, this human leech, and it is the duty and interest of the working class to use every means in its power to oust this parasite class from the position which enables it to thus prey upon the vitals of labor. Therefore, I say, let us organize as a class to meet our masters and destroy their mastership. Organize to drive them from their hold upon public life through their political power. Organize to rent from their robber clutch the land and workshops on and in which they enslave us. Organize to cleanse our social life from the stain of social cannibalism, from the preying of man upon his fellow man. Organize for a full, free, and happy life. For all or for none. Marching down the Sandbow Street with a starry plowing high. Her dogs are set as an army, but the face to the sky.